Chairman, sir. Thank you very much. On behalf of my party, Shromani Akali Dal, stand here to support the budget. First of all, I'd like to congratulate the Finance Minister and the Honorable Prime Minister for a bold, revolutionary and a futuristic budget. Every section of the society has been taken care of by the budget. And in a few words, if you have to say about the budget, this budget concentrates on rural India, the poor and the farmers, which are the majority where Indians live. And if you are able to uplift them, I think nobody can stop the growth of the country. I must compliment the Prime Minister because he thinks big and he tries to achieve big. Any nation who has a Prime Minister, a leader who thinks big, always takes his country ahead. And this can be seen from this budget. If you look at there are a lot of highlights of the budget, I don't want to get into all of them. But few areas which I feel are important, where he's tried to look after the interests of the poor and the farmers, I'd like to mention. One best thing which the Honorable Prime Minister and Finance Minister has done is providing 6,000 crore support, 6,000 rupees an acre support to poor and marginal farmers. Second major step and a bold step is that he has announced that by 2022, every citizen will have a house, electricity, gas, water and toilet. I think it is a very major target to achieve and I must compliment the Honorable Prime Minister. Another area which I cannot stop by without saying it is this medical insurance of 5 lakhs per family. Today, a lot of people die, especially in the rural areas and in poor areas of the urban area, without lack of medical facilities and lack of money. By providing medical insurance to the citizens of India, I think a major step has been taken by the Finance Minister and the Prime Minister. Sir, besides that, the Prime Minister has tried to encourage corporate India by reducing tax by 25%, has tried to build 18 tourist destinations, which is very important because tourism is one of the highest earners for any country. And I must compliment the Prime Minister also for stressing a lot on food processing, and the Honorable Minister here has also done a good job. That's what I said. In his last Mann Ki Baat, the Prime Minister talked about water. Water is going to be the biggest problem we are going to face. And if we don't put our minds and the brains behind it, we are going to face a major crisis. I have this data from the Central Board of Water Board, Central Ground Water Board, Government of India. They have categorized, they have mapped out all the blocks of the country and they divided them into four areas. Some are known. First is safe blocks, where there is enough water, semi-critical blocks, critical blocks and over-exploited blocks. So you will be shocked. The state which has the highest number of over-exploited blocks is Punjab. 80% of the blocks in our state are overexploited. And how are they overexploited? For providing the nation food. Sir, the whole nation depends on monsoon. Good monsoon, you will have a bumper crop. A bad monsoon, the crop will, there will be no crops. Farmers will commit suicide. They will be in rural area, will be in crisis. State, one state, which even if we have bad monsoons, and the last 10 years, 6 times we have less than 50% monsoons, 50% less monsoons in the last 6 years, in the last 10 years, but our production has been increasing. How is that? Because we have been using our canal network and exploiting through ground tube wells. Sir, our farmers protect their crops like their child. They can sell anything, they can use diesel sets, electricity provided by the government, but they won't let our crops die. And because of this, our production has been increasing. And we today, Punjab today alone, which constitutes 2% of the land area of the country, provides 45% of wheat and 35% of rice to the country. Sir, if this does not, if we don't help, if the now the nation does not help us, I think in 10-15 years, Punjab will become a desert. Sir, today the state which has been feeding the nation needs to help it now. Sir, this is a very critical situation. And there are a lot of ways Government of India can help, and the State Minister of Finance is sitting, and the budget also talks about saving water. We need immediately money for rebuilding a canal system. We need money to rejuvenate our groundwater reserves. We need to create bunds. We need to create ponds. We need to create a lot of things. And we need the full Government of India's concentration and help to save the state. Because just imagine if Punjab stops growing wheat and rice, there will be food crisis in this country. And we, if India has food crisis, we will be importing food from rest of the world, and then the world will have food crisis, because to feed 1.3 billion people, which Punjab used to feed, and we can't, if you can't feed them, and if they import, then you can imagine the scale of problems which will happen in the country and the world. Sir, we need to encourage farmers of Punjab to diversify into less water consuming crops like maize and others. Yes, the Prime Minister has announced MSP for these crops, but unfortunately governments are not buying at MSP. MSP is just on paper, but farmers in distress are selling crops at much less than MSP. Unless we do not ensure, like wheat and rice are bought by the government, same way Government of India through the state governments should buy all the alternative crops at MSP. And I think Government of India should keep a budget, special allocation to buy these alternative crops. That's one of the ways. Second, sir, every state which has a national reserve gets royalty. Rajasthan, Assam gets royalty on petroleum products. A lot of states get on marble, coal, all other mines. Punjab has been mining water for the nation, and now Punjab is not getting anything. It doesn't get anything. Even our water has been given to the state of Rajasthan, and we have been not paid for it. Rajasthan canal was built by that time Indira Gandhi ji, but we were not compensated for it. We have not got anything for it. And as per riparian laws, the water is the right of the state on which the rivers cross. Rajasthan had no right, but still, water was given to that, but still we have not got any compensation. So one of the major concerns of a state today is saving our groundwater, and Government of India in this budget and the future budget should come up and save the state which has been saving the country. The second important issue, every state has a capital. Punjab is the only state in this country does not have a capital. Every state capital contributes 10 to 35% of the GDP of the state. So just imagine, Bombay is taken away from Maharashtra. What will be the financial position of Maharashtra? If Hyderabad is taken away from Telangana, Chennai is taken away from Tamil Nadu, Ahmedabad is taken away from... Because taken away, what I mean is, if they made union territories the way we are facing, our capital Punjab is, we don't have a capitalist, is union territory. All taxes accrued in our state from our capital, all industry in our Chandigarh, income goes to Government of India and not a rupee comes back. This is the, I think we need justice. Sir, Just look at it. One example, Mumbai contributes to GDP, Mumbai's GDP is $210 billion. Bangalore's GDP is $83 billion. Hyderabad's GDP is $75.2 billion. And Chandigarh will be also a couple of billion dollars. But we don't benefit from it. And that is one of the major crises which we are facing, which we need Government of India to restore our capital. Or till the time its decision takes place, at least the revenue should go back to our state. Sir, third issue. Yes, we were promised Chandigarh. Every state which is formed from the old state, the original state retains the capital. Our is the only state. New state has been formed. We have not been given the capital and we are without a capital. Sir, another very important area, sir. We face the border with Pakistan. And because we are facing a border with Pakistan, the land has been fenced. And approximately, sir, about 17,000 acres of our agriculture cultivable land is on the other side of the fence. Farmers can't go there to cultivate the land. Even if they allow them, they give them 4 hours window a day, or sometimes they don't do. Those farmers are suffering. There are 212 villages and 11,000 families which are being affected by that. And during the Vajpayee's, when he was a prime minister, that time he came to the border and he started giving 2,500 rupees an acre to the farmers whose land is on the other side of the border. But unfortunately, after that, they have not received anything. So request the finance minister that either you acquire that land or you compensate them for their land, at least 20,000 rupees an acre. Sir, by having land the other side, it is also leading to drug smuggling. Because the windows are open for a few hours, and if you see, you might have heard in the papers, Pakistan is not in providing terrorism, it is also providing narco-terrorism to India. It is attacking millions of our youth through narco-terrorism. You might have read in the papers 425 kgs of cocaine, heroin, was caught by the customs from the Wagah border, 425 kgs, just a few days ago. So this is the scale of Pakistan's designs in our country. So this area of a border fencing and the land which is on the side, which we always used to get compensation, we have not got compensation. So I request the Honorable Finance Minister, in the budget a special provision be made in that. Sir, another important area, sir. We are not against giving incentives to our neighbors. They should be given. Jammu Kashmir should be given, Himachal should be given, Uttarakhand should be given. They have the right, they should be given. Plus, but sir, why have you created an island among all of them? Our state, one side is Pakistan, other side is Jammu Kashmir and Himachal. We are an island. Last 20 years, no industry wants to come to Punjab because they would prefer to go to Jammu or they want to go to Himachal or Uttarakhand. We suffered during partition. We suffered 20 years during terrorism. We suffered, we don't have a capital. Our water level has gone down to 700 feet and the rate it is going, trying to feed the nation, I think in another 15-20 years, we will become like a desert like parts of Rajasthan. Sir, if we don't have any industry coming in. So the worst part is, lot of industry from Punjab dismantled the units and shifted to Jammu Kashmir and Himachal. So what is the purpose of killing one state? Please, why can't you add our state to the package? If you can't do that, at least the border area should be given. So keeping all this in mind, sir, I like to congratulate again the finance minister and the prime minister, but I like to request them, the 4 points I've raised which concern the state of Punjab, and state of Punjab existence and the prosperity of state of Punjab is very important for the nation, because that is a state which has been providing for last 50 years food to the nation. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Next speaker.